So I was thinking, when we're doing the Ouija board, if you know, it's supposed to be a doorway.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
If we can set up Riffy's trigger object.
Yeah.
Is it all ready to go? We put a coin in
a trigger
something.
Object. We just got the pad. I don't know what to use the trigger object.
A coin.
Coin. Yeah. Got coins.
Yeah. And we just see if you can ask something or whatever.
Yeah.
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 That'd be good.
I think one set up.
No, I had an aura reason weeks ago. Instead of all like sort of psychic stuff.
Alright.
I've had like a couple of really bad experiences like the last couple of weeks. And I something I'm actively working on.
Cool.
So I might be some use to you know better.
You don't mind it getting taped and things, do you?
No, no.
Absolutely
brilliant.
Okay mate, sit down.
Riff.
Which hand?
I don't know.
That's called into that case of the week, Rob, because of the demonology background and stuff.
Oh, right.
The one with Dan that touched on where he'd done the soup and all that, but he wanted to be there for that, and I did pick up on the presence there.
Cool.
So.
Cool. Might be an interesting night tonight then.
Hopefully.
Hopefully. Right. What we do on this one is, once you've done these, what I'll do is set this off and that just get a base reading, just forget about that, just try and keep your hand as still as possible but relaxed on that. You can keep it flat down, you know, don't keep your hand stressed up or anything because it'll pick up on that.
That's getting it on your knee.
Yeah, like that, on your knee. And I'll start, whilst these are on, you'll see the light start to get brighter, the flashing. And when it's comfortable for you, just say, that's it, or stop. And I'll stop and then you'll hear the tones as well. You want the tones and the light to be enough to, so you can clearly see them, and the tones to blot us out. But
not too loud.
But not too loud, so you know, and don't open your eyes while this is on. You view through your closed eyelids. Don't open your eyes. Fry your retinas. We don't want that.
We promised to fry it tonight, but...
TC, TC, do you mind if I take your hand to your leg weight?
Yeah.
Not allergic to mask and tape, are you?
No.
Not allergic to adhesive? No.
No. I seem fine, boss. This is all coming to like all the laptops and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Let's explain the theory for some reason on the balance.
What we've got the mixer board is, because of the frequencies that we need to go through there, on the computer at home, I've got a software oscilloscope.
Okay.
So the frequencies that we programmed into these, we know it's damn close if we can get them. Yeah. So, you know, we've got those pre-programmed.
Right.
So everything, every frequency we want Dean to hear,
yeah,
he will, or the binaural beats anyway, and the one that he is in the middle is going to be banged on.
Yeah, that's fine.
That's better, she's got it over, honestly.
Alright mate, if you do feel you need to give a running commentary, feel free or whatever. Or if you just want to sit there quietly and enjoy your... Am I in the way?
Is it a new set of beliefs or is it just the same beliefs?
It,
Thank you.
creative process of doing it around and register it, you know, in those MRI scanners.
Yeah.
But,
yeah.
You know, when you're actually thinking of something, you know, the brain says, how do you record someone's ESP? You know, those figures that I got from the internet could be just fairy stories, but they could be true.
I mean, if there's a similarity between the experience you get and what the frequency is supposed to do, then, especially with everybody doing different ones, because it sounds like everybody is saying the same thing.
Maybe if they have, say, 100 people, that could be ESP.
Suppose the other one would be to maybe do it in...
It's got green up.
That's just doing it, so right now you can actually pick out
the little thing you said that will say he's close or he's miles away. But I'll need to find one for Griffy because I just send it, there you go, get the report.
Yeah.
Rob can, you know, say, you have to.
The things to spend your time.
People see the light flashes in this program, so we try to spell. Now, with these talents, you can actually have music on broadcast them underneath the music talent as well.
Some people don't like the auditory side and they'll just look at the light side and concentrate on that and see how far we can get, you know. To change colour and go down. I've been using that for years.
Yeah.
And you know, at stressful times at work, even without that, I just can get myself down before I throw a bloody monitor at somebody.
I think I'll have to get one of those well drowned.
Things in advance with it.
Yeah.
No one's got a specific one, except you.
I would see the lights of the box on the camera.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. No, I mean, it's the, that camera's not going to do that.
On the screen?
It's very creepy.
That's
our proof.
So you've got the fucking knowledge. This is when you're going deeper to the camera.
Yes.
Like the alpha waves and stuff like that.
Exactly.
Well, oh, the weather not going to go. It's ready for that.
It's a lot of people for that.
They might have a bit of film. Yeah, it's good. They might see that they might go.
Yeah.
They might have a problem then. What would it go to if they were to sleep? But they won't go.
The program's designed to bring you life.
But it didn't. It's not always going to be.
It does bring it back into the conscious, yeah. It's just that because that's when you stop. So, is it finished?
Yeah.
Because as I say, I could still hear the tone of that, so I thought
I could still hear the tone.
Yeah.
And then, I need to start to go.
And now, it went to the next one.
paper box that I'm going to leave it in the morning. Just for you.
Oh, my God.
Thank you.
distance there.
It doesn't look that very happy.
Just a bit of
space.
Apart from that bag.
Of experience.
Yeah, kind of. Yeah, a couple of them things.
Devils, yeah. What say?
Devils.
Yeah.
But,
yeah. How long do you feel like you've been out for?
Just a little bit. It doesn't seem that long. That long.
Yeah, 41 minutes.
Seems like about, what, 10 minutes max?
Yeah.
Do you see him in it, or?
Yeah, it's kind of like the end.
What was it? Was it patterns or anything?
I had a pattern thing going on the first time, and the first time that went on. And then, like a chessboard thing.
Yeah.
Like a twisting chessboard.
Yeah.
And you're falling like right dead centre and going straight for it and going into another one. And then a concave ball type thing. And then just, it just went great.
Yeah. That's interesting, that's something you shouldn't see either.
Yeah, it just went great. And then fell into like a green board. And then near the end.
When you say you fell, did you have the feel on the floor as well?
Yeah, it was like three-dimensional.
Yeah.
So it was like, you were falling and it was like twisted.
Yeah.
It was like falling straight down and then at the end it was like, it was like I was getting a load of hands, like a kaleidoscope.
Yeah.
With like a figure in the middle. Bought the hands for their mound, but they were standing straight there.
Yeah.
Can I change
the because it's dead bizarre, because you can see colour change, and then, we'll say colours, green.
Yeah.
Just can see the green. You can see it when you've got your eyes closed, you can see it's pretty much blurred.
Yeah.
And it's the green. It's like a flask. There's not much going on there.
Yeah.
The red, I'm getting a right big kick from.
It's shaking.
The red.
Yeah.
And then orange thing was at the end. I was getting a really big hit off the orange, but
yeah.
Not three-dimensional hit. The red was three-dimensional.
What do you mean three-dimensional?
It was three-dimensional. I was getting like a wall.
As though you were in a passageway, that type of thing?
Although I was looking out of a window, and I could see like a flat surface, and then things going on behind the flat surface.
Yeah.
I was getting clouds, moving.
Yeah.
So like there was something going on. And then the last bit with the orange, it was almost like seeing an old fashioned film.
Yeah.
So it was like everything was moving quickly.
Right.
Yeah.
So how did you personally feel about it?
I'm kind of calm and relaxed. A bit edgy at some points. The three-dimensional thing was a bit weird.
And when did you experience that?
That was when it was going like, I got that from the green into like, the red was like this three-dimensional thing, and it was just like four.
How long did you reckon?
As far as I know, it only lasted, what, 10
minutes?
Yeah, max.
When you say you felt calm, what was the feeling of calm?
The grass, the green, when I was looking at the grass, it was calm. Because everything was black.
And it's funny that it's the green as well, because it was green on the
bottom. Yeah, the green made...
You went below levels of calm. You went super calm.
You wouldn't believe how many levels of calm you went into.
And you just kept dropping and dropping, but it was literally a straight drop.
But the thing is, you were seeing red and green, weren't you? Or bits of orange?
I've seen orange at one point.
Yeah.
And then
Everything just went white.
Yeah, oh, you saw white then. Did you not see kaleidoscope of different colours?
No.
That's interesting because a lot of people see different colours.
I was getting, when I had the orange and I got the hands, the figure was in the middle, I was getting like a 3D kind of colour.
Yeah.
But to be honest with you, my eyes were like getting a water up to that point. So I don't know if that was just coming off that.
Yeah.
It's a good feeling. I could feel him just doing this bit of nothing this way.
Yeah.
But green was mad. It was like comfy.
Yeah.
And everything was comfy about it.
It's weird the way some parts of it like that.
It was dead bizarre, and then all of a sudden it just went white.
Yeah.
But I mean, it was like whitey grey. Now see, you can have white, but you can see like a cloud on it, but it wasn't moving. It was just white. And then it all went mad again when the colours changed. I could feel the colours changing.
When you were like seeing things, like seeing the yourself falling and Jasper, was it really vivid? Or was it just the impression of it?
No, it was really, really vivid.
I could actually see it.
Yeah. I could actually see it, but I mean it was twist.
Yeah. Yeah. I've had a couple like that things twist.
Oh, I wasn't getting like twisted, and I was going right in the middle and kept on going through the middle. And there was no one underneath, just that kind of effect. So, probably, like you were saying, like spiral staircase, it's the same kind of principle, but with like chessboard, isn't it? Go through. But I could actually feel myself passing through chessboard, it was about that thick. You could feel yourself just passing straight through.
Isn't that cool? Because you can remember the thickness of it.
I can remember you can see it from your past, it was like, that's what I was saying, it was like a 3D image.
Yeah.
So like, you know, you're going close to it, like if you're playing a piece game, you're going close to it and then through it.
Mm.
So you can see, so to me it was like a solid object, and it was like, you might as well have just played the piece game.
Yeah.
And I can tell you, I could have picked it up without it.
Yeah.
And everything else, that's the idea, that was it. But I didn't realise it was out that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Isn't it amazing the way time, you know, perception just goes out the window?
Yeah, I mean, is that because you can talk to everything's going on?
I think it's something to do with that.
Oh, is that actually something to do with that?
Well, the Ganzfeld one, that is the total field, isn't it? It's supposed to take you out, you know, not give you any sort of sensory information. But on this, you do get sensory information because you're getting different sounds all the time and different lights all the time. Whereas on the Ganzfeld, you've got ping pong balls with just a red light.
Yeah.
You know. So I think that's why you get all this imagery from somewhere. I don't know what caused it.
Because I mean, as I say, different programs are given different imagery as well. So is that just the way the person?
I think probably.
Sees.
Yeah.
Because one thing I have noticed, more or less all the patterns I've seen while I've been older, they've all been twist and they've been spiral. Say not the last time it was triangles, it was similar triangles.
And you saw that, like eye?
Yeah. The other thing I saw, the RC and I. The pyramid, the triangle. The pyramid of the triangle. The triangle of the eye.
Yeah, we were artists in the person.
Yeah, that one, yeah. That was, and that other symbol, it was like a Celtic cross. When it came out, I had to draw it down. Even though I knew what it looked like, and I just had to draw it down. It was weird.
And the traditional Celtic cross, or more like that type of.
This
is more just a straight cross.
Just like that.
Yeah.
In fact, it had a circle around it.
Yeah. Do you want to do Stamford?
No.
It's the 8, 4, 5, and the middle is the square.
Because see where it's got the see around the circle and it's got the no cross in it, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
The gaps.
Yeah.
They have little lines shooting through them as well.
Please take more than one.
Nice one,
Back here.
Alan, throw it past the bit, throw the biscuit. Pass the bit to man, please. Let's see what you get, matey.
Soldier.
Mm. Well, man's superb.
No, I'm not sure. Show my compadre on the